So you're going to start by putting your titles in the title row. I'm just putting in 3 sprints for now so that you can see, but we'll add some more later. I'm also adding an average and a total column. And then I like to just clean this up a bit, make sure it's all centered. Just a personal preference. You obviously don't have to do that if you don't want to. And then you're gonna wanna format the date column so that it recognizes that it's a date. And that's useful later on when you make pivot charts, which we'll do at the end of this video. I'm gonna just put in some quick dates. Make sure it's all nice and centered. And then I'm just gonna come up with some quick numbers here. Now here's how you go about calculating the average. You're gonna go up here to this button under Home and click Average. And then you're gonna make sure that you have the right cells highlighted. And then here's how you do the total. You're gonna hit Sum in the same place. Now notice that it included the average there. I'll fix that when I'm done. You can just highlight and drag it to fill in subsequent rows. That's particularly useful when you start having more days. Let me just fill in more of this chart. The reason these totals are wrong is because it's also including the average, which is the E column, and you want it to just include the B, C, and D columns. So you just click on it and you change E to D in the taskbar. I don't know if it's called a taskbar, but we'll call it that for the sake of this tutorial. Do that for all the rows, or just do that. Notice how it's 0 right now because there's no data in these rows. And I like to add a total column here for the grand total so that I can keep up with where I am. And to insert more rows as you write every day, that's how you insert more rows. Say that you want to do additional sprints. Here's how to add more columns. Okay, so now we have 5 sprints. Here's how to update the average and the total. So notice how it says D2. You want it to also include E and F. And then you can just copy and drag it. It'll give you like an error message in the average just because it doesn't have anything to put in. But that's easily fixed as soon as you put data. Next, let's look at how we can make this look a little bit nicer. Go to Format as Table, and these are your options. If you don't like any of them, you can change your theme by going to Page Layout and then Themes and selecting from all of these themes. I think you can also download additional themes online. I don't love the font of this one, so let me go back. Okay, this is fine. So we're going back to Home, and then now we have all these new tables, and we want to select the whole table, so type in 10 to include that grand total at the bottom. And there you have it. Next, let's look at adding icon sets. This is conditional formatting. So go to the conditional formatting option. You have a lot of options here. I'm just showing you what I tend to do. So start by changing percent to number to make it easier on yourself. Unless you're like into percents or something, I don't know. And then change these values so that they reflect your high end and your low end. So like, what would you consider a green number and what would you consider a red number in terms of how many words you've written? And there you have it. But obviously it's only showing it in the total right now. So go back to apply it to the whole table. Select each column individually. And then hit OK. There you go. Now, anytime you put in a value, it should give you either a red, yellow, or green button to let you know whether or not you're on track. Next, I'm just gonna center these columns to make them look nicer. And then I'm going to add a notes column just because I like having a place to jot down any notes that I have as I'm writing every day. Some things that you might include here are just like notes about distractions you might have had, notes about like why your numbers are as high as they are. And I'm gonna recolor all of this because I like having a more uniform look. I like adding a total label here just to let me know that this is the grand total. That's kind of hard to read, so I'm gonna change it to white text, maybe. I don't know. Keep playing with it. I'm gonna add some more columns. Some numbers here. And now I'm just gonna like change all the dates to purple as well. Now it really looks like a bug, but that's okay because the middle section is gonna increase as time goes by and then it'll look nicer. Let me just add a February date so I can show you how I make pivot tables. Go to Insert and then Pivot Table. Make sure Table 2 is selected and choose New Worksheet. Select Date and Total and then drag date over to rows. So now you have this beautiful table, but you want to see how much you wrote in January and how much you wrote in February. So here's how you find that. Click group, drag this over so you can see, and then click months. If you want to see how much you wrote in a week, you can select days and then do like 7 days or however many days that you want to assess. And there you have it. Now you might need to refresh the table anytime you add more data. The way to do that is just right click on the box and hit refresh. It should refresh the totals to reflect the changes in your other chart. However, sometimes it will break the grouping and you just have to follow the steps again. I hope that was helpful, but let me know if you have any questions and I will talk to you again soon. Bye.